IVC filters used to prevent strokes are defective and dangerous. The FDA knows it and does nothing about it. See the story at drugsafetynews.com.
Tomorrow is the real Super Tuesday, with the primaries in Florida, Ohio, Illinois, and several other states. The difference here, especially for the Democrats, is that most of these states are winner-take-all. In Florida, we have over 200 delegates for the Democrats up for grabs. In Ohio, the number is closer to about 150. So if Bernie Sanders were to take both of those states, along with Illinois, he could finally become a Democratic frontrunner and show the nation that he has the power, he has the support from the people to overthrow Hillary Clinton and take the nomination. On the flip side, if he loses these battles and Hillary Clinton racks up 400-500 more delegates tomorrow, that could be the end of Bernie's campaign. I know that's not something that most of our viewers want to hear, but it is a reality. It will create a gap between the two candidates that will be almost impossible to overcome. Now, sure, if he were to sweep every other state after Tuesday, he could get the nomination. But with Clinton's momentum, with the corporate money behind her, that seems increasingly unlikely. But victories tomorrow, just like he showed in Michigan, where polls had him more than 20 points down, he could really upset this race and change American politics for the better. On the Republican side, it's likely going to be a Donald Trump sweep once again. Tomorrow, if not by the end of the day, then by the next day, we should see the end of the Kasich campaign and the end of the Rubio campaign. Marco Rubio has been spending millions of dollars in his home state of Florida just to try to close the gap between him and Donald Trump, but right now that gap is still more than 20 points. Marco Rubio's campaign is officially over, even if he is not willing to admit it. Now, this means tomorrow Donald Trump could solidify his status as the Republican nominee. I know nothing's official until the convention, but wins tomorrow in these states, which are swing states, that could push Trump over the edge and make him the Republican nominee. And the fact that these are swing states is what is so important about tomorrow, because finally we're going to get a real sense of where these swing voters stand. If Florida goes for Bernie, if Florida goes for Trump or Cruz, we're going to see a shift. We're going to see that the polls don't necessarily represent the will of the American people, the desires of the American people, because the people being polled, you know, polls are never 100% accurate. And any poll with a margin of error greater than 3% should not be trusted. That is according to political science research methods. It's one thing that those of us who majored in political science, have degrees in political science, it's one of the things that we are taught. Anything over a 3% margin of error should not be trusted because that margin is too great. So tomorrow is going to be very interesting. It could also be very disappointing. But for the first time in this primary race, tomorrow is going to give us some real answers.